Hey, what's up everyone? Neil Scyther here. Time to get started on our next little YouTube project, which is a minimalist run of The Legend of Zelda, A Link to the Past. And as we kind of let the title screen intro play here, a couple of notes about this. So if you don't know what a minimalist run is, it's essentially going through the game, but I'm only collecting the items absolutely required to finish the game. And I've got an Excel spreadsheet next to me here, which lists everything that is required. Which means, during this run, I will be allowed to get the Fighter Sword and Shield, Pegasus Boots, the Book of Medora, Power Glove, Lamp, Moon Pearl, Magic Mirror, Ice Rod, Fire Rod, Can of Samaria, Hammer, Shovel, Flute, Flippers, Master Sword, Ether Medallion, Quick Medallion, Bow, Silver Arrows, Hookshot, and Bombs. Which means I am not allowed to get any of the other sword, shield, or armor upgrades, the Boomerang, which that'll be a fun one to skip, the Bombos Medallion, the Mushroom, the Magic Powder, Net, Bottles, Cane of Byrna, Magic Cape, any other pieces of heart, or any heart containers that do not drop from a boss. Now, there are a couple asterisks next to a couple of those, namely the Silver Arrows and the Ice Rod. I've seen speedruns where people have beaten Ganon without Silver Arrows. I've seen people beat Trinex and Turtle Rock without the Ice Rod. But as far as I know, they are kind of required, or they require a certain way to defeat Ganon and Trinex respectively. I don't know the details about that, so... I mean, the Silver Arrows don't come until the very end anyways. And the Ice Rod... You know, just notice, that king looks like a skeleton. Tch. The king of Hyrule is a Stalfos. Anyways, the Ice Rod I can technically get any time. So, if I find out that you can beat Trinex without the Ice Rod, and if I can figure out how to beat Ganon without the Silver Arrows, I may skip them. And two more things for the record. First, this is actually my second attempt at doing this, because the first time I started, I literally got all the way through the first palace. And when I went to make the videos, and edit them and everything to put on YouTube, I realized I had the music so turned down, you could not hear it hardly at all. Like, I could barely hear it. The other thing to note is, this is the Wii U version on the Virtual Console. Reason being is, if you have, I'll say it right now, inspiration for this actually came from Roman Mithril's minimalist run of the original Legend of Zelda. As you can see, I've already got a file started. And now the file is gone. And he, because of the way he has to do his recording setups, he does what's called a refreshing pause to make sure that the video and audio don't desync. I'm not going to be doing refreshing pauses, but I'm going to be kind of doing the videos based on how he did his in a way, where he would do one video that would incorporate getting to a dungeon and getting through it. This is pretty much going to work the same way. Though later videos, as the dungeons get bigger, might have to be split up into two videos. Remember the first time I played this game, I could not pronounce the wizard's name for the life of me, or I couldn't figure out how to pronounce it. I don't know, I always thought it was Agnim or Aghanim, Aghanim, I have no idea. So imagine that, we're playing a Legend of Zelda game and we have to find Zelda. These all hearts. So let's go ahead and nab the lamp. Now if you don't get the lamp here, you actually can get it in the dungeon. The reason why it's required is because you do eventually have to light torches to be able to open doors and such. Otherwise, I could completely skip it too. Yeah, don't mind me, just going over to this, totally not secret passage. Nope, nothing down here, just a hole. Just gonna fall to my death here. And this is how we have the sword and shield. None of that is dangerous to go alone stuff here. So, getting through the first little, I'm not gonna really call it a dungeon. The first task is to go to the dungeon area of Hyrule Castle. Not this. This doesn't count as the, well, it's a dungeon, I guess. Your first goal is to go into the castle proper. There. Come on. There you go. Not that I need it, but yeah. So here we need to make our way to the dungeon, which isn't too terribly difficult. So since this part of the run is relatively easy, I mean, for the most part, this run's going to be simple for at least a little while. Well, simple as in it's not going to be much more difficult than it would be normally. Because, for the most part, we are playing it normally. So, as I make my way through this nice dungeon, I will say I am allowing myself maps and compasses as well. But I really don't feel like getting lost in these dungeons that I haven't played in a while. That being said, Link to the Past is my favorite Zelda game. Which I know some people are thinking, oh my god, you don't... Your favorite's not... Whoa, this is turning out bad already. Come on. Let's do this. There we go. Okay, that about turned out really bad. There we go. Okay, now that the beeping has stopped. So some of you might be thinking, oh my god, he doesn't like Ocarina of Time. What's wrong with you? Or... Ocarina's not your favorite. I like Ocarina of Time, and I like Majora's Mask. There's not... If you don't count the CDI games, there's not really a Zelda game I don't like. And that was completely useless. I don't know why I did that. Avoid the guards. There we go. So there's not really a Zelda game I don't like. But I've always been into the more classic and retro-styled games. And out of the... Especially with the Zelda games, the I love the top-down style of Zelda games, like the original Link to the Past, Link's Awakening, the Oracle games, and so on. And with that being said, Link to the Past has always been my favorite. I think it's kind of like my relationship between Metroid and Super Metroid, where I always prefer Super Metroid. That's because it's like the original, only bigger. So here we have the first casualty of not having a boomerang, the ball and chain trooper. Thankfully, he goes down to two pots. As you know, Link likes to break pots and jars and stuff. You fear your worst for the father. Well, if he's anything like we saw in the opening, he's already a skeleton. Yes, I kind of understand that. I'll get some rupees here out of the chest. That's going to be the fun part of this for me, is remembering what chests have heart pieces. I don't believe there are any heart pieces in the dungeon. They're all in the overworld, so... I just got to make sure not to open any chests in the overworld. That'll be fun. So the goal now is to make it all the way back to the... Pretty much the beginning. It would help if I hit the right button. And that's where this comes in. Bit of a shortcut here. You know, in case you don't want to fight all these guards again, which... Considering how that went the first time, I really don't. Ha! Kind of seemed kind of cruel, but okay. Thank you. And we make our way up to the throne room, which of course has guards that we're going to completely ignore. Guess guards don't know how to climb stairs, apparently. Yes, apparently this is on a set track. And you have to push from the left side. Yeah. Navigating this without using the lamp isn't too bad. But, you know, I got it, might as well use it. And of course, just like the original Legend of Zelda, this one has snakes that are not quite as annoying, thankfully. But of course, being the first dungeon of the game, you have to have your obligatory snakes, bats. I'll be back for you. Told you. And of course, now we're at the sewers underneath the castle. I gotta question the architect who built sewers underneath the castle. Or built the castle on the sewers, I guess. But again, not too hard to navigate, whether or not you want to use the lamp. Now, if you ever need rupees, you can come back later with either the bombs or the Pegasus boots and bust open that cracked wall, and well, you get rupees. But that means kind of going back through this again, which, you know, who really wants to do that? And of course, we're Link, so we gotta hit things with jars. It is the Link way. Yeah, I love how she says, pull that switch over there. But she doesn't say which switch. Yes, I know how to pull a lever. So, for the record, if you happen to pull this switch, you can bombard it with snakes. Insert snakes on a plane joke here. And with that, we're already done with the first quote-unquote dungeon. So, yes, I understand I must go find a Master Sword, blah blah blah, you're gonna keep Zelda safe. I'm sure that'll really work out great in your favor. And with that, that brings us to the end of the first video here. Yeah, I know it's only been about 15 minutes, but these videos are probably going to be a bit shorter than my normal videos just to start out with, as I'm only going to do one dungeon per video. So, with that, we will be picking up next time and going towards the first dungeon proper / palace / whatever you want to call it. So with that, I thank everyone for watching, and I will see you next time.